फ्रेंड्स, हाउ आर यू? आई होप एवरी वन इज डूइंग फाइन. एंड दिस इज अनदर सेशन ऑफ वन डे वन केस सीरीज. टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक, एंड दैट इज अर्टिकेरिया. यू टेंड टू सी अ लॉट ऑफ केसेज इन ऑफ अर्टिकेरिया इन योर डे टू डे ओपीडीज. अलॉन्ग विद दैट, इट इज़ अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट केस फॉर योर अपकमिंग, और द क्वेश्चन फॉर योर अपकमिंग एंट्रेंस एग्जामिनेशन, वेदर इट इज नीट, पीजी, आईएनआईसीटी और वॉट एवर एग्जाम यू आर गिविंग. ओके, सो आई रिक्वेस्ट ऑल ऑफ यू टू प्लीज बी लाइव एवरी डे. I'm taking three sessions. In the morning, I take a session at 12 p.m. Then I take another session at 4:30 p.m. and another session at the 8:30 p.m. So I'm coming every day for three sessions. I request all the dear students to please be live for these sessions as well. Okay? Now, little bit of my introduction. I'm Dr. Cheshta Agarwal, your NEET PG educator on An Academy, and I've myself scored All India Rank 261 in my entrance examination. Now, currently on An Academy, please remember, everybody knows that the NEET PG exam has been postponed. It. So, keeping that in the mind, we have just now introduced a 3+1 offer. For example, if you use the referral code Dr. Cheshta YT, if you use my referral code Dr. Cheshta YT, you will get 1 month extra if you subscribe for 3 months of An Academy Plus subscription. Please remember, this is a very limited period offer, and I don't want anybody to miss these, okay? So please try to be with me for the next few minutes. It will be a short session of 15-20 minutes, but you will be, all the questions related to Articaria, you will be going through that. Now, we have another very important offer, and that is for the Iconic subscription. Now, we have a limited period offer. If you buy an Iconic subscription now, you will get it in a very, very amazing discounts. Look at this. Now, the previous amount of a 3-year subscription was 92,000 rupees, which has been reduced to 58,500, which is like 1,000 rupees per month, a very, very cheap course, which you can definitely get. Okay, so if you are planning for the next pattern examination 2022, I request you to please go ahead with this limited time period offer for Iconic subscription. Don't forget to use my code, that is Dr. Cheshta YT. Don't forget to use this code. This is very important for subscription of An Academy. We have around 34,000 questions here on our platform. You just need to download the An Academy learning app. These questions are present for free. So there are a lot of things which are present for free on An Academy. So please subscribe to An Academy using the referral code Dr. Cheshta YT. Many batch courses we have already started. For example, the Target Next batch, the FMG Test and Analysis batch. Then we have NEET PG Session 1 and INICT MCQ Marathon Session. I want all of you to please be part of any of these courses, whatever is required for all of you. Try to be a part of them. Starting with the first question of the today's class, I want all of you to please answer the question. 22-year-old woman, small itchy wheels after exertion, walking in the sun, eating the hot spicy food, and when she gets angry. What is the most likely? Answer a very, very easy and interesting question. I'm waiting for everybody's answer. A 22-year-old woman develops small itchy wheels after physical exertion, walking in the sun, eating hot spicy food, and when she is angry. I request all the students to please answer the question. I hope I am visible right now. All of you, please give me a quick thumbs up. I hope I am visible right now. Yes, there was some problem with the connection. Yes, so very nice, Gaurav and Purnima. I've seen you after a long time, Gaurav and Purnima. I hope everyone is doing fine. And I'm seeing that suddenly, when the news of NEET PG postponement have been announced, the students who were coming to the classes have reduced. Please don't do that. That is not what is required from you, all of you, right now. What do you have to do right now is, along with your postings, you have to keep your studies at max. Please do not stop coming to the class. I can see a sudden dip in the number of students, okay? So please don't do this, okay? Now, all of you are right. The answer of this question is option number one, that is cholinergic urticaria. Now, what do you mean by this urticaria word? I'm so many times I've told you this urticaria. Can you tell me what you mean by urticaria? So I'm using a new blank slide for all of you. What is this urticaria? We'll use two slides for this. Yes. Okay. Purnima, please don't get tense. That is why I'm trying to take classes every day for you. Purnima, I'm also coming up with the anatomy classes from tomorrow. Tomorrow at 4:30 p.m., I will be taking class on embryology. So I request you to please try to attend all my classes so that you will not feel tensed. Now, what is urticaria? Urticaria is a cutaneous disease which presents clinically with veal formation. Now, what is veal? Veals are nothing but transient means it remains for less than 24 hours. These are transient erythematous. Please look at the words which I am using. Look at the word which I am using. So transient erythematous, edematous, papules and plaques. And Purnima, I'm again requesting, if you have yet not subscribed to Unacademy, please try to get a subscription now, because it is worth buying a 4-month subscription, because it will maintain a flow which is required at this point of time. If you will not join any of the course or any of the online or offline coachings, this can interrupt your flow of reading. So please stick to one of the online or offline coaching centers, whatever you feel is comfortable for you or you help or which helps in your understanding. Try to stick on it. If you are thinking of Unacademy, then please don't forget the code Dr. Cheshta YT. Okay. Yes. So what is a veal? It is a transient erythematous, edematous papule and plaque. Now, how it is formed? Now, what happened? The primary cells in the pathophysiology or pathogenesis of urticaria is mast cells. So what are these cells? These are the mast cells. There are many factors, for example, infection, drug, autoimmunity, that is IgE mediated. There are so many factors, infection, drugs, even the food allergen. What does these things or these agents do? They will go and cause degranulation of the mast cell. And what happens when there is degranulation of the mast cell? Anybody can tell me what happens when there is degranulation of mast cell? Please remember, mast cell consists of preformed mediators. And what are those preformed mediators? These are histamine. So you have release of histamine from the mast cell. What does this histamine do? This histamine causes vasodilatation, which is responsible for erythema and edema. It causes activation of the nerve ending, which causes itching. Now please give me a quick thumbs up if everybody understood what is the basic mechanism for development of urticaria or veeling. There are many factors which can cause the degranulation of the mast cell. So what are the causes of urticaria? These are infections, drugs, autoimmunity and food allergen. All together will cause a degranulation of the mast cell, which cause release of the preformed mediators or the granules, and that is histamine. And this histamine, which is released from the degranulation, causes vasodilatation as well as it causes itching because of stimulation of the nerve ending. Very, very important concept. Now coming to the question. Now question is saying that only those times when the patient is having increase in the core body temperature, look at the question. Only when she goes out in the sun, eat hot spicy food, and whenever she is angry, only during these periods she could see presence of urticaria. So whenever you have increase in the core body temperature, whenever you are increase in core body temperature, it activates the preoptic area of hypothalamus, which then cause release of cholinergic sympathetic pathway. It causes activation of cholinergic sympathetic pathway, which cause release of histamine, giving rise to cholinergic urticaria. Understood or not? Very important concept. Please try to remember. If you understood the basis of urticaria, everything becomes very easy for you to understand. Okay, so please give me a quick thumbs up if you understood what is the first question. Maria, Purnima, Gaurav, everyone. Yes, now few points which I wanted to discuss here again is, urticaria has been divided into two broad categories, acute and chronic. Can you tell me what is acute urticaria? When the duration is less than 6 weeks. And what is chronic urticaria? When the duration is more than 6 weeks. What is the commonest cause of acute urticaria? Infections followed by drugs. And what is the commonest cause of chronic urticaria? It is the autoimmunity, that is the IgE mediated autoimmunity, which means IgE mediated pathways. Autoimmunity, which is the IgE mediated pathway. So please give me a quick thumbs up, all of you, if you understood this point. Very important. Pritika, welcome to the class. Gaurav, Purnima, Maria, everyone is welcome in this session. So we are doing the questions related to the urticarias, and I hope everybody is clear with the first question, the basic of the pathogenesis of the urticaria, as well as the types of urticaria. Now coming to another question. Let's see how many of you can do this question. A man takes peanut, develops tongue swelling, striders, hoarseness of voice. What is the probable diagnosis? Pritika, Gaurav, Purnima, again requesting all of you, if you like my classes, please subscribe to Unacademy. Use my referral code Dr. Cheshta YT to avail the amazing discounts on the platform. To avail the amazing discounts on the platform. Very nice. So now everybody is writing the answer as option number one. And yes, you are right that it is angioneurotic edema. But one thing came into my mind, that what is the difference between urticaria and what is the difference between angioedema? In both of them, you have cutaneous swelling because of release of some of the mediators, but it is not exactly what you think. Now, I will tell you the differentiating point between urticaria and angioedema. Please remember, in urticaria, you have edema, which is limited to the dermis. But in the patients of angioedema, edema extend up to the subcutaneous tissue. Okay, so we are done with the first difference. The second difference is, what is the mediator in the patients of urticaria? We have just now read, it is histamine, which comes from the mast cell. But in angioedema, you have a lot of mediators. Along with histamine, you have bradykinin, you have kallikrein, you have prostaglandins, leukotrienes, etc. So you have a lot of mediators including the histamine which is involved in the pathogenesis of angioedema. I require a thumbs up from all of you if you understood till here. Now coming to the third important difference, or the fourth important third important difference, clinical feature. These patients will complain, the urticaria patients will complain itching, but what will be the common complaint of the patient of angioedema? They will have burning sensation, or even sometimes they can report pain, but there is no itching in the patients of angioedema. Very important question and differentiating feature. Now you may get a question which tells you the similar complaint, and the similar complaint which is given here, development of tongue swelling, stridor, hoarseness of voice, all these features are also seen in the anaphylactic shock or anaphylaxis. But the only point which differentiate anaphylaxis from angioneurotic edema is the absence of itching in the patients of angioneurotic edema. Very important question, please try to remember this. Now it is obvious that I've told you here that this is mainly including the dermis, so you will have only the cutaneous swellings in the form of veils. But in the patients of angioedema, you can see the tongue swelling. You will see the presence of laryngeal edema, etc. And all these features can cause obstruction of the obstruction of the respiratory tract. Okay, why no itching, Maria? Because see, here the receptors are little bit different. Okay, the mediators which are released, they instead of going and causing the itch sensation, they cause the pain sensation more. They go and activate the fiber C. I hope you all understood that the nerve fiber C is responsible for the pain and burning sensation. So they go and activate the nerve fibers which carries the pain sensation, and that is why they don't have any itching in them. I hope that is clear to all of you. And obviously, if there is no itching, there is no histamine, you cannot treat these patients with antihistaminic. You have to give steroids to take care of these individuals. But for urticaria, if it is not compromising the respiratory tract, you have to give antihistamines as the drug of choice. Now, if this is clear, I request all of you to please give me a thumbs up. Very important question in urticaria: how to differentiate a case of urticaria from angioneurotic edema. So all these three slides, number one, number two, and number three, are very, very important for all my dear students. Okay, everybody give me a quick thumbs up if you are done with the second question also. Very nice, and I'm very happy, Maria, that you understand. Again, I'm requesting, Maria, see, these are only few questions which we could discuss on the platform, that is the YouTube. I request, if you want to understand the topic more in detail, if you want to prepare yourself for upcoming NEET PG, please subscribe to Unacademy. Use the referral code Dr. Cheshta YT. Okay. Now let's do another question given on your computer screen. So good evening, Achan. Very nice to see all of you today. Very happy to see all of you. Please answer this question, everyone. Yes, good. Okay, so a 5-year-old child with multiple hyperpigmented macules on the trunk, on rubbing the lesion with the pen, he develops urticarial veils which is confined to the border of the lesion. Okay, so very, very important question: what is the diagnosis here? Yes, this is a classical case of urticaria pigmentosa. Now, what is this urticaria pigmentosa, and how does the patients of urticaria pigmentosa presents to you? So please look at the image. Please look at the image. This is how the patient of urticaria pigmentosa presents. This is how the patients of urticaria pigmentosa presents. Okay, now what do you mean by urticaria pigmentosa and what is the basic defect in these individuals? What happens in these individuals, you have collections of the mast cell inside the skin. So this is an example of mastocytosis, where there is accumulation of the mast cell inside the tissue. Why there is accumulation? Because of c-kit gene mutation. And the commonest form of mastocytosis is urticaria pigmentosa, in which a child present to you with hyperpigmented lesions as shown in these images. Very clearly seen in Indian skin, you will see a very similar picture which is shown in this image. Now, what is given in the question? The question says that when the lesions were rubbed with the round end of the pen, he develops an urticarial veil which is confined to the borders of the lesion. Can you tell me what is this? Anyone? Maria, Purnima, Pratika, Achan, anyone, Gaurav, what is this called as? On rubbing the lesions of urticaria pigmentosa, the lesion becomes red. Very nice. This is called as Dreyer's sign. Clear? Yes, this is called as Dreyer's sign. Now, what do you mean by Dreyer's sign? Look at this. I hope this image becomes a very clear image to you. Whenever you rub the lesions, what happens? There is degranulation of the mast cell which is present. And I have told you what happens when there is degranulation of the mast cell. There is release of histamine. The histamine causes vasodilatation, causing erythema and edema. And it will also go and stimulate the nerve endings, and that will cause itching. So the lesions which is seen on rubbing is called as Dreyer's sign, which is positive in the patients of urticaria pigmentosa. Please remember, it is positive in the patients of urticaria pigmentosa, but this is not exclusive to urticaria. You do have other conditions also where you have Dreyer's sign positive, and that is histiocytosis, leukemia, xanthogranuloma. In all these conditions, you have Dreyer's sign positive, and there is pseudo Dreyer's sign which is seen in the patients of smooth muscle hamartoma. What is the pseudo Dreyer's sign? Pseudo Dreyer's sign is nothing but whenever you rub the lesions of smooth muscle hamartoma, whenever you rub them, there is sudden piloerection. And whenever there is piloerection, you will have little bit raised appearance of the lesion. That is called as pseudo Dreyer's sign. Please give me a quick thumbs up, all of you. This is a very important topic. You can expect these questions in your upcoming entrance examination for sure. Okay, whether it is INICT, FMGE or NEET PG, whatever exam you give, these questions are very, very common and very, very frequent. Again, I'm requesting all of you to please be live at 4:30 p.m. also, because we will be starting the anatomy classes from tomorrow onwards. I request all of you to please be... Aman says that you see Dreyer's sign in mosquito bite. So that is not exactly the Dreyer's sign, Aman. Because in Dreyer's sign, you have mast cell degranulation. But whenever the insects bite you, they are not causing any degranulation of the mast cell, okay? That is a hypersensitivity reaction which occurs secondary to the bite of the insect. I hope you understood this. There is difference between both of them. Although they look similar, but they are not exactly a insect bite reaction, okay? And please subscribe to Unacademy. Dr. Cheshta YT is my referral code. I hope and I wish to see you on board with us on Unacademy. So try to be the part of Unacademy group, okay? And clear your exam with amazing results. Chalo, we have a lot of questions. All of you ready for the questions? We have a lot of questions with us. So please get ready for the questions. Okay. Not this one. This is a question which I wanted to ask. The chronic urticaria is defined as the duration of disease more than. We have already gone through this question. Anyone? Ritika, Maria, Aman, Gaurav, Purnima, Achan, very nice. We have a lot of students with us and it feels so good when, you know, there are many students in the class. I request you to please come on the Unacademy live classes also. You can attend this special class anytime because they are free of cost. And if you like, you can attend my plus courses also. But for plus courses, you need to subscribe to Unacademy using the referral code Dr. Cheshta YT. We have an offer going on right now that if you buy a 3-month subscription, you will get a 1 month for free. So please utilize the benefit of this scheme. Okay. So you all are right. The correct answer is chronic urticaria is defined the duration more than 6 weeks. This we have already discussed and that is why I don't want to go more in detail. Another question, omalizumab. What is omalizumab and how do you treat them? Mani, Aman, Achan, please answer this question. Okay, so before telling you the answer of omalizumab, you should know what is omalizumab and what is the treatment of urticaria. So please remember, the treatment of urticaria becomes a very, very important part. There's a lot of confusion how to treat a case of urticaria. So for that, I have made a treatment letter. Okay. So this is the treatment letter of urticaria. Whenever a patient of urticaria comes to you who is not having any respiratory discomfort, please remember, respiratory discomfort hai to steroid dena hai. But if there is no respiratory discomfort, whether it is generalized or localized urticaria, you don't have to give any form of steroids. You will start the patient directly on the antihistaminics, which should be from the second generation, because first generation have a lot of sedation, second generation usually do not have that much of sedation. Now you will give it for 2 weeks. Two things can happen after 2 weeks. Either the disease will get improved or disease will not improve. If it is improving, you just keep on continuing the antihistaminic. But if it is not improving, you have to increase the dose of the same antihistaminic. It is not that you have to change it. You have to just increase the dose of the antihistaminic which is already given to the patient. Again, you will wait for 2 weeks. If the patient is doing fine, do not do anything. Keep on continuing the same antihistaminic. But if the patient is not doing fine, now you have to add either omalizumab or cyclosporin or montelukast. Any of these drug can be given. Okay. Now this is very, very important. Now what is omalizumab? Please remember, omalizumab, yes, it is given for the asthmatic patients, but it also works in the patients of urticaria. It is a humanized, please remember, humanized monoclonal antibody which is FDA approved for the treatment of the patient who is more than 12 years of age and those who have chronic urticaria. So this is very, very important point. Please remember this. You have to give in a dose of 300 mg monthly, which is given in a subcutaneous dose. So what is the answer of the question? What was the question asked? The question asked was, what is omalizumab? So omalizumab is nothing but a humanized antibody. It is nothing but an humanized anti-IgE antibody. Okay. Yes. So nothing, Maria. Local application will not improve urticaria. In fact, it is told that if you give oral medication, it can exacerbate urticaria. So never give oral medication, topical medication in the patients of acute urticaria because it can even exacerbate the condition. So I think we are clear and also we are done with the today's session. Please give me a quick thumbs up if everybody have understood this session. It was a half an hour short session. I hope you have enjoyed it. Please join Unacademy using the referral code Dr. Cheshta YT because these are just the trailers. Picture abhi baki hai mere dost. And for watching the movie, you have to download the Unacademy app and just use the subscription, taking the referral code Dr. Cheshta YT, and get the benefits of both these schemes. These are very, very important. Okay, Aman, even in pregnancy, you will manage urticaria with antihistaminics only. You have to choose a safer antihistaminics like CPM, which is considered to be a safest drug in the patients of pregnancy. Okay, so bye bye all of you, take care, good night, all the best. I expect everybody will be live tomorrow on the three sessions at 12:30 p.m., at 4:30 p.m. and 8:30 p.m. Bye bye and take care.